Hello folks, welcome to KSP Academy. Myself Praveen Kadpala. Today we are going to discuss the basic important concepts in the transmissions and distribution system. That is nothing but underground cables. So what do you understand by underground cables generally? The underground cable is nothing but we have a conducting material. Underground cable is nothing but conductor which is possessed by an insulation. Conductor which are possessed by some insulation material. This is what insulating material. Conductor plus insulating material is nothing but a cable. Conductor plus insulating material which will call it as a cable. Generally the cable is nothing but conductor plus insulation is nothing but a cable. The cable you can use in the underground is called underground cable. Underground cable is nothing but conductor plus insulating material. Conductor plus insulating materials is nothing but underground cable. Basically these underground cables we are using in the power systems. They basically we use a single core cable and three core cable. If we keep one conductor in this insulating material, one conductor, that means single phase core. If we use one of some three phase power transmission and keep three conductors inside, it's a three phase cable. But if it's a single phase, you can use that this cable systems. So what is the main intention of this underground cable? What are the advantages we have to see by using of these underground cables? The advantages of this underground cable. The basically what why we should go for underground cable is compared to overhead transmission lines, these underground cables are very good for the public safety, because you are keeping in the buried in that after keeping in the underground cable, which is very benefit to public safety, which are having more public safety better. Next, one more important thing is that this underground cables having no corona effect. It's a very less effective it takes place. Very less effective for corona it takes place in underground cable, which are not accountable also. But more important thing is this underground cable having more power transfer capability. How we can say more power transfer capability means, as we know, ZS equal to under root of L by C, surge impedance. Underground cable capacitance is increases, correspondingly ZS is increases. So what is the surge impedance loading? VS square by ZS. ZS is decreases, SIL going to be incremental. So therefore, the power transfer capability is going to be incremental in the case of this underground cable. I hope you're understanding. Next, one more important, less chance to get fault in the case of underground cable. Because in the over overhead transmission lines, tree falling and all after in the case of in the summer case, winter case, due to the climatic conditions, you're getting more number of problems. Faults will take place in this. But you are taking the less chance to get a fault in the underground cable. So what the drawback of it is there? What the disadvantage of underground cable? The major disadvantage of underground cable is, if there is a fault is takes place in the underground cable, there is a fault takes place in the underground cable, the identification of fault is a very difficult task. Now presently we have number of advanced methods to identify the faults. That is one thing. Even if you identify the fault, or the fault, you need to clear it. You have to go again, you have to dig that and open the cable, and you have to do the work and close it out. Again, it will take a lot of time to do this thing. Compared to overhead, the problem identification and do the repairing cases are very tough cases. Problem identification and the repair is a little difficult. It is difficult, it's dangerous. One more important thing, cost of underground cable very high compared to its overhead cable. Compared to the textbook knowledge, the cost of underground cable is 13 times cost of overhead transmission line. The cost of underground cable is cost of overhead transmission line compared to 13 times it will move less. So that means it becomes a 10 to 8 times. So according to your textbooks, you are adding 13 times the cost of underground cable to these overhead transmission lines. Next, let's switch on to that one more introduction part in this. Basically, what are the properties we need to consideration when you go for this transmission line? So we have to go for properties of your underground cable. What are the properties we take this? The major important property, the first one is the insulation underground cables having high insulation resistance, because it should not interact with other transmission lines, so it should maintain high insulation resistance. Next, it should maintain high dielectric strength. You have to maintain high dielectric strength. One more important thing is this cable should be mechanically strong. Therefore, we can say that good mechanical strength, the third important point. The fourth, very very important, it should be non-hydroscopic. This underground cables are non-hydroscopic, nothing but it should be free from moisture content. It should not absorb the moisture content. That's what it should be free from, a non-hydroscopic. The next important thing is it should maintain a low permittivity. It should maintain a less permittivity. Next, one more important thing is low thermal capability or low thermal coefficient. Better. So less thermal coefficient, even the better it is. Next, one more important thing is these are the cables, it should withstand for high voltages. That's a very good cables. So if you look at that, it should withstand high rupturing voltage, nothing but it should withstand for a high voltage stress, that also the cable should withstand. These are the important properties that are having high insulation resistance, high dielectric strength, good mechanical strength, it should be non-hydroscopic, low permittivity, low thermal coefficient, high rupturing capacity, how to maintain when you are designing the cables. Next, when you go for underground cable, what type of material we have to use for underground cables? So the materials we can use for underground cables, we can write next year, which one of the materials. What type of material? Insulating material, we can see that. Insulating materials. What type of insulating material we have to use for an underground cables, basically? The material, we can say that we have many number of materials. Out of that, what is the regular usage of materials? I can write down. Number one, we can say that vulcanized Indian rubber. If you use this as an insulating material, we can use your voltage stress is 10 kilovolts to, as you can write that, 10 to 20 kilovolts per mm. For every 1 mm, we can bear the 10 to 20 kilovolts of stress potential gradient that it should bear, that if you use a vulcanized Indian rubber. Second thing is impregnated papers. This we can use generally in the transformer. If used in these cables, the impregnated papers, which will bear that is 30 kV per mm. The dielectric strength or potential gradient, we can go for 30 kV per mm. The one more important thing, we can use PVC also. PVC means what? Polyvinyl chloride. If you use PVC materials, which you can wear up to 17 kV per mm. Up to 17 kV per mm, it can bear the dielectric strength of the material.
Last thing is we can use polythene material. Polythene material. If you use the polythene material, which is then up to that 20 kV per mm. There are dielectric strength is 20 kV per mm. These are the four important materials what are used in the present market. Vulcanized nanobars, impregnated papers, PVC and the poly. According to the potential gradient of a cable, we can select it is. Out of this, basically we are using this polythene material, we are using in our regular applications. Which are the insulating materials, properties and advantages and disadvantages of your underground cables. I hope you are understanding. If you like my lecture, please subscribe. Links will come to your mind if you can enjoy. In the next class, we are going to discuss the construction of cables. How you need to construct the cable, we will discuss in the next class. Thanks for watching. Keep continuing.